Dear students, I will start chapter 14, water. Yesterday, we discussed about to show the presence of water vapor in air and to show evaporation and condensation, both the process takes place at the same time. And today we will discuss about how are clouds formed. You know that in the process of water cycle, first process is the evaporation. And evaporation, what is the evaporation process? The heat of the sun changes some water into water vapor, and that water vapor being lighter, and it rises up in the air, and when it collect together by the condensation process, it takes the drop, then it changes into the water drops, and when it is collect together, then it forms the clouds. And when clouds become heavier, then in the form of rain it comes down. You know that clouds are made up of droplets of water. When in the second process of water cycle, when water vapor changes into the droplets of water, these droplets of water forms the clouds. And clouds are made up of droplets of water, ice particles, and particles of dust and air also. And the lower parts of the earth atmosphere is full of water vapor. The water vapor is not visible in the air because it is a gas. Water vapor is not visible because it is a kind of gas. So clouds are formed when some water vapor condenses. Only when it condenses means changes into the droplets of water, means changes into the liquid state, because in that it is the gas. So when it changes into the liquid state, that is by the process of condensation, then it forms the tiny droplets of water. And if the air is cold enough, the water will form ice crystal instead of droplets. And dust is very important constituents in the clouds. Dust is very important constituents in the clouds. And in the air, there are salt particles from the oceans, ash particles from volcanoes, tiny bits of rock and soil blown off the land, and soot particles from the factories and forest fires. These particles attract water molecules and give them a place to gather into the droplets. And without dust, it would be difficult for clouds to form. Without dust, it would be difficult for clouds to form. And the main reason for the formation of clouds, what is the main reason? The main reason is the formation of clouds is the warm air being lighter up, light and rises up, and however in the air rises up, it cools down, and the warm air can hold a large amount of water vapor, and when this air cools down, high up in the atmosphere, and it can no longer hold a large amount of water vapor. Thus, the excess water vapor condenses on dust particles to form the clouds. And it has been found that lesser the water vapor in air, cooler, it should become so as to form a cloud. And that is why on a dry day, the clouds are very high in the sky where it is cold, coldest. Sometimes in winter, the condensation of water vapor takes place near the surface of earth. This in turn forms fog, which is actually a cloud touching the surface of the earth. And clouds are categorized based on their shape and height in the atmosphere, as shown in figure 14.6. Precipitation or rain, you must have seen that many a time clouds appear in the sky but do not cause rain. You also know that clouds are the collection of very very small particles of water floating in air and sometimes tiny droplets of water under suitable conditions come together to form large sized of drops of water, and these large drops of water are heavy and air cannot hold them, thus fall towards the earth in the form of rain. And the falling of drops of water from the clouds is called the precipitation. In water cycle, three processes are involved: evaporation, condensation and precipitation. So during the evaporation process, water changes, the heat of the sun changes some water into water vapor, and water vapor are lighter and rises up in the atmosphere. And when by the process of condensation it changes into the drops of water, when the drops of water collect together, then it forms the clouds. And clouds, when it drops of water becomes heavy, when clouds becomes heavy, then air cannot hold the large amount of water, so in the form of rain it falls down to the earth. That process is called the precipitation. So three processes are there: evaporation, condensation and precipitation. So sometimes the raindrops freeze while falling towards the earth. Such a precipitation is called the hail, because in between cold air is there, and when it is coming down to the earth it forms hail, which is a frozen state of water, and the main reason of precipitation is that clouds cool off. And this happens in two ways. First one is the clouds rise higher in the atmosphere because they are warmer and lighter than the surrounding air. Clouds rise higher while getting over high mountains, and in either case, on cooling, the precipitation takes place rapidly and hence the rainfall occurs. Next process is the water cycle. I told you in water cycle three processes are there. First one is the evaporation, condensation and precipitation. Water cycle, it consists three process: evaporation, condensation and precipitation. So you are familiar with water. It occurs in the liquid state. You know that water occurs in the liquid state. Let us try to understand the meaning of the term cycle. What is the water cycle? Take a simple example. Imagine you are taking a walk along a circular park. This is a circular park, and return to the same point after completing one cycle. Similarly, the earth rotates about its axis in 24 hours and completes one cycle. When it will start from here and it will come like this, then when it will reach this point, means it completes one cycle. And any natural phenomena which repeat itself after some time is said to constitute a natural cycle. Water cycle has a similar meaning. We shall try to explain it later. every year about 11 quadrillion means 11 billion gallons of water evaporates from the oceans into the atmosphere, and at the same time plants add up more water into the atmosphere, and if this water drops, water does not return to the oceans, they would dry up in 2500 years. But this does not happen. The amount of water does not change in the oceans, and evaporated water returns to the oceans in the form of rain by various routes. If all the water vapors rises up, means in the form of water vapor, only evaporation process takes place and precipitation process will not take place, then what is the water is there if it will not return? Then one day will come like this, all the water becomes dry from the different stream, from the oceans, from the rivers, from the lakes. All the water, it dry. And when it comes, when it will come through the rain by the process of precipitation, then it through the different streams, through the various streams, it will go, it will reach to the oceans, lakes, ponds, rivers, etc., different streams. So this cycle is repeating again and again. If this cycle will not repeat again and again, then one day will come like this, all the water evaporates only and no water is there. So actually this cycle is repeating again and again after completing one process. So the whole cycle is called the water cycle. And the journey of water, what is the water cycle? The journey of water from the oceans to the atmosphere and back to the oceans again. The journey of water from oceans to the atmosphere and back to the oceans is called the water cycle. Water that rises into atmosphere from the oceans may return it in us, or it may sink into the rocks and million of years to return. And the journey of water from oceans and back is explained below. Till here you will take revision, what is the water cycle, and till here you will take revision.